Tim was just like...
Good evening, good evening, good evening, guys.
I think he was done. Done and doneer.
Done and doneer, yeah, I think so. Hey guys, this is Epsilon 4 here. We are back with School of Dragons tonight.
Woohoo! School of Dragons!
Woohoo! School of Dragons! Anyway, we were going to play an old game called X-Wing vs. TIE, but unfortunately my computer had a conniption hissy fit and said no. And that's also why I'm late on stream, because... yeah, it was bad. Several reboots later, and we're playing School of Dragons, so that's what we're doing tonight. How's your day going? So, let's see. We did finish up our last quest. We saved, what's her name? Rain? Ryan? No, not Ryan. I don't remember what her name was, but anyway, we saved her a couple times and fixed her dragon, whatever. So, we did that. I think we've gone through all the basic training quests. So we're good there. So we're gonna have to find some more questings. And see what there is to do. First, however, like always, we're gonna go fishing. Hey puppies, gonna go to bed? Good night, gooches. All right, let's see here. There we go. I'm getting better at it. Anyway, how's your night going? I hope it's going great. It's going okie day. Was following the house proceedings. I think I mentioned last night they're getting ready to signy die, which means the end of session. It's kind of like a French phrase or something. I don't know. Whatever. Let's see if we can get something other than eels out of this pond this time, huh? I have to actually. There we go. Look how sparks. There we go. Let's buy some fish. Oh, I don't want to use that. Uh-oh. All right, where's the stores? That's what I need, the store. Well, I guess I have to use my minnow. Remember, I didn't want to use the minnow. Anyway, a little perchy perch. I'll take that. So what was I saying? Oh yeah, so the government, the House of Representatives and the Senate are getting ready to close their session, which we call signy die. And while I was watching that, they recessed until tomorrow, 10 o'clock. So we'll see if signy die happens then. Just never know. All right, nice little perchy perch. You have run out of bait. Yes, that's what I wanted to do before. Okay. I don't know why I can't do that. All right. I probably can, I just don't know how. So, let's buy some more wormy worms. All right, here we go. All right, now we can do some fishing. There we go. All right. So, I was kind of expecting to have to be up all night tonight anyway, but looks like I'll get some sleep and Hopefully the house will sign he die tomorrow. And now we'll move on to gaming news. like I said, I want to do X-Wing versus TIE, and we are going to do it. But because it's such an older game, I think the graphics just kind of conflicted with my streaming software and... Ah, an eel. What the heck do we want an eel for? Anyway, it just was bad. So we'll try to get that fixed and do that another day. Here we go. Come on. There are a number of other older games that I want to try streaming too, so it'll be good practice to get that going. Come on, eel. Come on. Stop that. Get out of there. I gotta buy a new fishing pole, but I need more diamonds. Come on, get. Oh, these eels. Too bad I can't have Sparky shoot the eel. And then I could cut them up for bait. That would be a good use for eel. Just saying. Just saying. So, other than that, what do we got going on? Oh, yeah, we got a big holiday coming up, don't we? 4th of July. Independence Day. Mr. Fireworks Day, dreaded by veterans. Come on, Salmon. No. Oh, I'm going to lose him, huh? Come on. Yep. Knew it. All right, let's try again. Oh, goodness. So, I guess 4th of July, we're going to go up the hill to Pine Top and... chill it with some friends of ours. Should be a nice weekend. It'll be fun. Taking a couple days off work. So that'll be fun. Come on, little brown trout. Oh, no, get up. No. Come on, stop that. Get up here. There we go. Let's do it again. So, what are your plans for the 4th of July? You gonna have fireworks? What does your family do? Barbecue, hot dogs, hamburgers, marshmallows, s'mores, all that good fun stuff. Nice little fire pit or campfire. Maybe you guys are going camping. Camping's always fun. I like camping. Oh! Another eel. I need no more eels. Is there a bait they have that eels won't bite on? That's a good question. Is there a bait the eels won't bite on? Because really, I have no use for eels. Do you? Come on. No. We are doing terrible. Let's go to the store. Let's see how much that fishing pole is. I hate to waste good coin on fishing pole. Yeah, see, that's 85. I don't have that kind of coin. Right? I just have to earn some gems. Well, let's finish. Maybe we'll do that in a minute. Let's finish our bait off. Back over here. We got three more casts. Ooh, a salmon. I want the salmon, but I know I'm not gonna catch it, right? Come on, come on. What are you doing? What are you doing over here? Hey, we're not doing good today. This is not a good sign, my friends. This is not a good sign for our stream today. It's got to get better. Got to get better. I'm gonna need some viewers. I'm gonna need some chatters today. You guys are gonna have to help me out. This is not jiving. We got a perch. I think we've got 2 fish out of 10 baits. It's really not good. All right, last bait. Let's go. Come on, give me something good. Here we go. Brown trout. I'll take a brown trout. I could use a brown trout. I still don't have my first 10 brown trout. Come on. Nope. Get out of there. Get. Ah. Come on. Quit being so feisty. Come on. There it is. All right. Let's stop fishing. Ooh. All right, let's see. Backpack. So what do we got? We need one more brown trout. One more to make our 10. We got this a long time ago. 7. Perch, herring, halibuts, 1 salmon. And a beginner rod. Oh, I could throw it away. I don't want to throw it away. I'm going to need a fishing rod. All right. Okay. You know what? Let's give it one more shot. Maybe we can catch that 10th brown trout. Let's try it one more time. Come on. Come on, guys. Come on. Let's do it. Go to the bait store. Let's try a glowworm. All right, one glowworm. Just one. Only one. Let's go. Come on, brown trout. Come on, brown trout. It's a brown trout. Now if we could just not lose it. Come on. No. Other way. Ugh. Come on. I just realized I should probably quit my video. Anyway. Cool. All right, we got a 10 brown trout. What do you think of that? That's good stuff. All right, let's go to the store because viper fish. Oh, I can buy these, huh? With diamonds. Why does everything cost diamonds? How about gold? I got plenty of gold. I can buy stuff with gold. Hideout furniture. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. Let's see. Earn gems. Let's see. Is there anything we can earn gems? Earn free gems for every friend that registers. Oh, yeah. We'll just earn them in game. Okay. All right. Well, let's stop fishing. And let's see. We need to We need a quest. That's what we need. Topics. Is this the leaderboard? News, leaderboard, achievements, equip. What's this? Come on. All right, go here. Profile. Quests. No quests available. Why not? I want a quest! All right. Well, fine then. Let's go back to the school. And we'll do some flying. And then we'll see what happens. Oh. All right, here we go. New quest. Headmaster. Well, let's go see the headmaster. There's Harold. Hey, Harold, what's up?
Are you ready for your next lesson? You'll learn how to live out in the wild. Just you and your dragon. Or as I like to call it, lesson no toilet paper. The first step is to go find Garber in the wilderness. There's a hidden pathway here at the school. Good luck.
There's a hidden pathway. All right, Headmaster Harold. I guess we take some spare toilet paper. That's what I think. None of that no toilet paper thing. I don't think so. All right, let's take the quest. And then, oh, look at that. We get to follow the arrow again. Let's go follow the arrow. Follow the arrow around the world. Follow the arrow around the world. Probably should make that cave harder to find. Of course, it's pretty easy with a big fat arrow pointing to it, right? Oh, here we go. Here we go. Where are we going? Let's use the bridge. Come on, Sparks, keep up. Uh-oh. Ooh, fishy fish. Look at them fishy fish. All right, who are we looking for? We're looking for Gobber. That's mulch. Not mulch. Gobber. Gobber, gobber. There's Gobber. Welcome to the... Oh, he talks. Not much, but he talks some. All right, welcome to the wilderness. It's time to test your skills, your survival skills. I hope you're ready for a challenge.
Think you can handle it?
It's time to put your back into it. You can use your axe to cut down small trees and turn them into logs. You'll need 6 logs to make your hut. Okay, let's go. All right then. Hey, look, there's a wilderness. Is that what they call a wilderness? Those are tiny trees. I don't want to cut those trees. What? Lemoid, I want to cut these trees. Why can't I cut these trees? These are trees. These are little sprout trees. They got growing to do. These are big trees. Let me cut these trees. I want to cut the tree. Oh, well. All right, fine. We'll murder the little key trees. Let's do it. We got 2 out of 6. Murder the little tree. Oops. There we go. 4 out of 6. And one more tree gotta do it. There we go. There we go. 6. Great farm. Thanks, Gob.
Let's get started.
Now go find 5 stones in the area and bring them to me. They need to be a specific size and shape. You'll use them for your shelter. All right, 5 stones it is, Gobs. There looks like stones to me. Oh, there's one.
Whee!
There's 2. No. Oh, fishies. Can I play with a fish? Yay! Come here, fish. I want to catch you. Come here. Oh, Sparky can swim too. Nice. Go Sparks. All right, here we go. There it is. Ooh, I like swimming. Swimming's good. All right, we need 1 more.
1 more!
Oh, ooh, that felt good. Sorry. Woo-hoo. All right, there's the last one.
Well done.
Took your time on that one. Well done, though. Hey.
I have a task for you.
To survive in the village, you'll need to find a source of water and food. There's a good fishing spot not far from here that will give you both. Mulch is already there. Go over there. All right, let's go find mulch. Doesn't that come off the lawnmower? Mulch? Mm-hmm. All right, where's Mulchy Boy? Right over bucket. Jump the bucket. Jump the bucket. All right, Mulch. Oh, find the fishing spot.
Good
there it is.
Job.
Joe, find it.
Think you can handle it?
Any fresh fish? Catch 1 brown trout for dinner. All right. I'm gonna need some bait. What should we use for bait? Let's try gold worms. I'm just gonna buy 10 just so I have them. So I don't know how many times it's gonna take to get a brown trout. Bye. Again. All right, here we go. Cast her in. Well, first time, nice. It's almost like it was planned. All right, come on, brown trout. Hey, I got a full gold star. I think that's new. Nice. No, let's get over here. Come on. Ta-da! Okay. Cool beans. Stop fishing.
You're a natural. Let's get started.
You're going to need to be as sharp as a sword to survive in the wilderness. This next lesson will test your eyesight. Runestones. Are our key to the past, and our ancestors wrote on them to keep a record. They're hidden all around this area. Find one. Okay, find a runestone. Hold on, we got to text that message from my buddy over there. All right, let's see here. We need a rune. Hello, rune. Rune, where are you, rune? Hello, rune. Oh, I think I see a rune. Oh, just a box, but I'll take that. Open chest. You found a herring. Nice. Okay. Let's continue on our rune quest. Woo! Ooh, we got another chest. Yeah. Chests are way more important than runes. You have insufficient gems. Do you want to buy gems from the store? No. Why do I have insufficient gems?
Just what I needed. Get over here.
Great job, Viking. Come back to me and give me the things you've collected. I'll be able to set up a nice little camp here with the wood and the stones. I'm looking forward to eating smoked trout. I didn't know that cost coins, though. I gotta be more careful. Okay, let's go. Come on, Sparks. Woo! Keep up, Sparks. Come on, buddy. Woo! All right. Return to Gobber. You're not Gobber. You're Mulch. Whee! Sorry, Bucket. Had to jump the bucket. You have 6 wood logs, 5 building stones, and 1 brown trout from your backpack. Yes, sure, why not?
Great work. Think you can handle it?
Let's see, Sparky is ready to help out, I bet. Dragons are pretty good at lighting fires. Click on this fire pit and get him to start the campfire. You might need to get close so your baby dragon can breathe fire.
Here.
All right, Gob. What's up?
I'm impressed.
Well, that was easy. You've breezed through this lesson with flying colors, Epsilon. You're on your way to becoming an ultimate dragon trainer. I don't want gold coins. I want diamonds. How do I get diamonds? New quest, Bucket. Oh, hey Bucket, what's up? We usually have blue landing fires so the dragons know where to land. What makes blue fire? I have no idea. Can you find out for me? Sure, Bucket. Meet Heather by the lab. Okay. All right, let's go for a ride. Come on, Sparks. Oh, it says I'm supposed to go down. There it is. Oh, he can jump too. Look at that. Oops. Let's go talk to Heather. Hey, Heather. What's up? What you talking about? It's really great to meet you.
Blue flames are really, really hot. I think there's other ways to make our flames blue, too. Let's find out together. We use the scientific method. That's a really useful way to solve problems in the real world. We'll use 5 steps of the scientific method. Problem, research, hypothesis, procedure, and result.
Okay.
The problem is the scientific question that will be tested in the experiment. Pick out a problem among the choices.
Pick out a problem. Ah, here we go. Scientific method hypothesis. Which of these is an example of a problem? Okay, Fish Legs has a secret collection of rocks under his bed. Not a problem for me. Fish Legs' mom might have a problem, I don't know, but hey, that's Fish Legs' problem. Have your dragon heat the sylvite until it burns. Not sure what sylvite is, but hey. All right, which rock will burn with a blue flame? Blue flame, that's the question we want an answer to. I think Tolbachite will burn with blue flames because it is found by hot volcanoes. Well, either one of these could be a problem, but this is the one we want to know the answer to, so we'll do that one. Choose the right answer. All right, great, you chose the problem. You know, In life, I really try not to choose problems, but, okay.
We'll need to figure out some chemical reactions to change fire color. Our next task is to do a little research. Research is the step in the scientific method where you find information that's already known about the problem you're testing. You can research things by talking to people about their experiences with the items we need to test. I'll put the list of things we need in your quest log. Astrid, Fish Legs, and Snotlout can help you get these rocks.
Okay, cool. Collect Tolbachite from Fish Legs. Okie dokie. Where's Fish Legs at? Oh, he's right there. I guess I don't really need the ride you, Sparky. Sorry, come along. Heal, Spark. Hey, Fish Legs, what's happening?
Here you go.
Fish Legs Ingram, at your service. I was so excited when Meatlug and I found this Tolbachite, but by the volcano. It was kind of scary with steam and gas everywhere. You can have my last piece. Man, Fish Legs, you are so generous. I think aliens just stole my Tolbachite. All right, let's go to Astrid. Oh, sorry, that's probably not good to do on stream. My bad. All right, let's see here. Ah, there she is. Hey, Astrid. What's happening?
Hope this helps you.
I found this rock salt when the lake dried up last year. It must have formed when the water evaporated. Why don't you use it for your experiment? Hey, thanks, Astrid. You rock. Aliens again! Wow, that's kind of scary. Okay, collect Sylvite from Snotlout. Alrighty. Where is Snotlout? There he is. You really would think these people would be farther apart. Okay. Hey, Snotlout, bro, what up?
I am the best Viking around.
Bet you are, man. Bet you are. Sup, I'm Snotlout, master of awesome. Hookfang and I found this Sylvite at our secret training island. Cool, huh? It's really rare, but I'll let you have it. For your experiment. Just remember, you couldn't have done this without me. You rock, Snotlout. due to man, also slightly conceited.
Come see me at the lab and we'll have some fun.
Well done. Come see me at the lab. All right. There goes the aliens again. All right. All right, Heather, what's up? We're back.
Now that we've done our research and collected facts about our items, we need to form our hypothesis. The hypothesis is an educated guess about how you think your experiment will turn out. Which of these is an example of a hypothesis?
No idea. Okay, scientific method procedure. Which of these is an example of a hypothesis? Have your dragon heat the sylvite until it burns. That's not a hypothesis, that's an action. Which rock will burn with a blue flame? That's our problem. And I think the telchapite will burn with blue flames because it's found by hot volcanoes. That's a hypothesis. And Fish Legs has a secret collection of rocks under his bed. That's just an odd fact about Fish Legs that really we didn't need to know, honestly. You know, it's his rocks, it's his bed, it's okay. It's all right, Fish Legs, we won't bother you about it, all right? This will be the hypothesis, though. Great choice! I thought so, too.
The procedure phase is where we test out our hypothesis to see if it's true or false. Let's choose the hypothesis that we'll test in the experiment.
All right, let's do it. I thought we did that already. Whatever. Choose your hypothesis. I think that sylvite will create a blue flame because it was found in a dry climate. I think that the rock salt will create a blue flame because it's formed from evaporation of water. Ocean water and blue water is blue. That is a hypothesis. Not a very good one. But then again, neither is the other one. I think telpachite will create a blue flame because it's found near volcanoes and volcanoes are hot. I think that all flames are red and we will not be able to find a blue flame. Okay. Let's see. I don't remember what makes a blue flame. I don't think. Yeah, let's just go with volcanoes. Why not?
Interesting choice. Okay, let's get on with the experiment. Toothless is really excited to help you out. Let's go inside the lab.
Burn the rock salt. Rock salt? Let's go burn stuff. Go! Dinner's ready. What do we got? Welcome to the lab. This is where we experiment with our items by following a series of steps that form a procedure. These are your experiment items. Click and drag the rock salt into the crucible. A crucible is a small pot used to hold substances when heating. Got it. Rock salt. In crucible. Got it. Instruments can be used in your experiments. Click on the bag to get your instruments. All right. Click on the thermometer instrument to measure the temperature of the item. Okay, 21.0 Celsius. You only need the fire action for this experiment. Click on the fire action button to heat the rock. There we go. Heat up the rock salt till it burns. Observe the record in the journal. And record in your journal. Right. Thank you. right, I guess we burnt it. Oh, there it is. Great job, you completed the procedure by following those steps. Click the result button to empty the crucible. Tip, you can click reset whenever you want to start the procedure over. Okay. Oh, reset.
Kabaka.
Right. Excuse me. All right, you have completed the first steps for the first item in the procedure. Click on the flashing arrows and follow the remaining steps to complete the procedure. Okay, heat up the telpachite till it burns. Observe and record. All right, hey. Oh. All right. Come on. Oh, look, he's a cat.
Meow. Meow. Meow.
All right, tail spike. Whoa, hello. There it is. All right, temperature. There we go. Now let's heat it up. Oh, there's the blue flame. All right, let's reset. And the Sylvite. Apparently, I can't pick up somebody. There it is. That's weird. All right, in she goes. Thermometer, please. Thank you. And come on, Toothless. 95, 160, 240, 249, 250. Ooh, purple. We found red, blue, and purple flame. Very nice. Thanks, Toothless. You're great. All right, experiment complete. Woo! All right.
Results to see how you did on your hypothesis. Your results are what you will use to analyze or figure out your conclusion at the end of every experiment. Let's see if you understood the steps in the scientific method. Come back to me for the final test.
Okay, great work. You proved your hypothesis to be true. Your results are the outcome of your experiment. You'll use them to analyze or figure out the conclusion at the end of each experiment. Very nice. All right. I guess we have to talk to her again. All right. Hey, Heather. What's up? Looking good today. All right. Let's see. Scientific method steps. What is the correct order of the scientific method? Research, results, problem, experiment, hypothesis. Problem, research, hypothesis, experiment, results. Let's go with this one. Great job.
You want to use my lab for experiments. You should go back to Bucket and let him know what you found out.
Righto. Thanks, Heather. You have a great day, girl. All right. that Bucket? That's Bucket. What you doing up here? You get around, buddy. I understand. Now I need to find some Talbachite to relight the blue flames. Thanks, Epsilon 4. You've been a great help. I would give you the very bucket on my head, but I need it. Well, then you wouldn't give it to me, would you, Bucket? That's okay. I didn't need your bucket, Bucket. You can keep your bucket, Bucket. I'll just jump over your bucket, Bucket. Alrighty. Let's see. Where we gotta go? New quest. See the headmaster. There's the headmaster.
I've lived in Burke my entire life. I'm proud of our Vikings.
Good for you, Harold. But I don't want to live in New Burke all my life, dude. Now that you've been here for a while, it's time to get you to know more about your fellow Vikings. Go talk to everyone about their clan. Make sure you pay attention. This information might be valuable later. Objective, talk to Valka. I actually think I did this already, but yeah, whatever. Okay, let's go talk to Valka. Come on, where's Valka? Valka. Hey, there's like a big thing here. I should probably use the bridge. Hey, Bucket, what's happening? Go back to New Burke. What are we doing down here? Interesting. Uh-oh. We need to feed our little puppy dog. I mean, dragon. Sparky needs a snacky snack. How about a halibut? About another one. All right, I know you're probably bored, Sparks. We got a lot of talking to people to do. Let's see this stuff out of the way. Where's Valka? Whee! Whee! You're a hiccup. I don't want to talk to you. I'm not talking to hiccups. Nope. No hiccup today. Sorry. Gotta go. Where's Valka? Hey Valka, what up? My son Hiccup Horrendous Haddock is the head of the Haddock clan. He's also the chieftain of Burke. I've spent much time away from Burke, but I carry the proud tradition of my family. Hey, good for you. All right, let's go talk to Roughnut. And in this corner, it's Roughnut. And there he is, live and in person, right here in New Burke. It's Roughnut.
Reign of terror.
Dude, my brother and I are proud members of the Torsten clan. We're from a long line of berserker warriors. Like you couldn't tell from looking at us, Gruffnut and Scruffnut are Torsten clan members you haven't met yet. All right. Thanks, Roughnut. You rock. All right. And now, Toughnut. You're not tough nut. You're tough nut. All right.
Oh, the mischief I could get into.
Those sideburns, tough nut. Telling you. All right, the Thorsten clan is the best. We never think before we leap. I'm so proud. Thorsten's skulls are really thick, too, so we're really good at head-butting things. Want to see? No, not really. Thanks, Tough Nut. Maybe another time. All right, let's go talk to Hiccup. Did I miss him? Where'd he go? Everybody keeps moving on me. No bueno. So I guess if I have to get that, then... Open chest, 36 coins. Man, that's lame. I don't do that. Bye. See ya! We missed the turn. There he is. There's old Hiccup.
Perk is rough around the edges, but I wouldn't live anywhere else.
The Haddock clan is known for being strong, but that's not really my focus. Our clan also has a long history of building alliances. Cool, huh? Cool, Hiccup. Rock on. Alright, I guess we gotta go find Snotlout. Whee! Now, are we Newberk or Burk? I don't remember. All right.
Everyone out there is going to know me as the best Viking from Burk.
You've come to talk to the best. I am a warrior of the Jorgensen clan. We're relentless warriors, and we're amazing at throwing weapons. Ghost not loud. My father, Spitloud, is a Jorgensen, and our clan also has Scablot. Wartlout and Burplout. Wartlout and Burplout. He's the record holder for the longest burp. Cool, huh? I could beat him. Totally could beat him. All right. Astrid. Whee! Hey, wait a minute. What? Hey. There we are. Astrid.
You never know when you'll need to use your axe throwing skills.
I'm from the Hofferson clan. We have a proud history of smart strategies. Be careful of challenging us on hand to hand. I'd hand you your loss in a second. In my clan, we also have Asfred, Asgard, and Asker. All right, go Hoffersons. All right, talk to Fish Lakes.
Smart Vikings are the best.
I am a proud member of Ingerman clan. Our clan has been written down in many history books as fun-seeking Vikings. That's why I read so many books, because it's fun. My clan members include Frog Legs, Pig Legs, and Wolf Legs. Pig Legs is really mad at Wolf Legs right now, though, since Wolf Legs keeps knocking his house down. Is that a Three Little Pigs reference I hear? Sounds like a Three Little Pigs reference.
Well done.
Let's see, there was a lot of information about all the different clans episode 4. I hope you took good notes. No, sir, I didn't take any notes at all. Sorry, Harold. All right, got some more gold coins. All right, new quest, Gobber. Well, you know, we're gonna take a break from questing, because my dragon is sad. And I don't like my dragon to be sad. That makes me sad. So what we need to do is find a good eel to shoot. But shooting eels makes him happy. There it is. See that smile? See that smile? Look at that. He is so happy. All right. Okay. Woo! Let's go up. There we go. All right, guys. Well, I think that brings us to the end of our stream tonight. We got some good questing done, just some work through stuff, really, mainly. Nothing really super exciting. But, you know, you got to start somewhere. So that's what we're doing. So let's see what's happening then. Today's Thursday night, so I will not stream tomorrow or the weekend. I will be back on Monday night. And Monday nights, I usually start around 10 o'clock. Sometimes a little bit earlier, but that's what we do. So I will catch you guys on Monday. I hope you have a wonderful weekend and enjoy the weekend. And we have 4th of July in just one more week. Well, that's exciting. Don't forget to see about some fireworks and all that good fun stuff. Get stuff for s'mores or whatever if you're going to do a fire. I love doing campfires. And fire pits, fabulous things. Anyway, yeah, that's about it. So with that, I'm gonna sign off for tonight. And as always, I will bid you adieu and take care of yours. They'll take care of you.